Welcome back to this next video, and in this video we are going to talk about the use of thymine instead of uracil in the DNA, or simply you can say that why there is thymine in the DNA and there is uracil in the RNA. If you compare the structure of the thymine with the uracil, the only difference between the two is that there is a methyl group in the thymine, and that particular methyl group is absent from the uracil. So the thymine that is created from the uracil in a process which is known as the methylation process. And during this methylation process, a methyl group is added to this uracil, and when the methyl group has been added to this uracil, it is converted into the thymine. Now this methylation process that is actually carried out by an enzyme which is known as the DNA methyltransferase. So this DNA methyltransferase is going to add a methyl group to this uracil, thereby converting this into the thymine. Now most of the methylated nucleotides, they are present in the coding region of the DNA, including the thymine. There are also other nucleotides in the DNA which have got the methyl group or which got methylated. But one of the important methylated group, that is the thymine. So most of the methylated nucleotide, they are present in the coding region of the DNA. And the reason is that the coding region of the DNA is the most important region of the DNA, because this is the region that is responsible for the transcription, thereby making important proteins and RNA in the cell and hence in the body. And these methylated nucleotide, they are present in very little amount in the promoter region. Now, what is the importance of this methyl group? Let us discuss this in detail. That why the thymine, which have got a methylated group, is present in the DNA, and why the uracil, which do not have any methylated group, is present in the RNA. The first important thing is that this methyl group is actually protecting the DNA from the action of the nucleases, or you can say becoming methylated makes the DNA invisible to nucleases. Now these nucleases, they are enzymes which have the ability to break down DNA and RNA, and different pathogens like the viruses, the bacteria or other invaders, they have the ability to destroy the DNA using their nucleases if the DNA is not methylated. Is the DNA of the human beings and other living organisms that have got the thymine, and the thymine have got a methyl group. This means that the DNA has been methylated, and when the DNA is methylated, these nucleases actually cannot act on the DNA of human beings and other living organisms, thereby protecting their DNA. Another important point is that the thymine have got specific or specificity in base pairing. If you talk about the uracil has more base pair affinity to alanine as compared to the thymine. But the problem is uracil can also pair up with other bases including itself. Now this means that the specificity of the uracil is not that much as compared to the thymine, because if the uracil can base pair with the adenine as well as with the other bases, that means it can induce mutations in the DNA. Now as the thymine have got this specificity only to base pair with the adenine, this means that the presence of the thymine in the DNA prevents mutation. Now, as I've told you that if there is uracil in the DNA, this can lead to mutation because of its base pairing with the adenine or the other bases. And if the uracil is used as a complementary base, it could be changed during the DNA replication and therefore can code for different amino acid and maybe for a non-functional protein. For example, if there is an adenine and if there is a uracil, so uracil is going to base pair with the adenine, but on the other side, this uracil can also base pair with the say for example guanine. So that means there will be a UG group which is actually inducing a mutation in the DNA, and if there is UG, that means that the coding region in the messenger RNA, that will be changed. The messenger RNA will code for an non-wanted amino acids, and therefore it can code for a non-functional protein. Now, by taking it down to a single conformation, now this methyl group restricts the thymine to base pair only with the adenine. What I mean by this is that, as I've told you, that the only difference between the uracil and the thymine is this methyl group. So if this methyl group is present in the form of the thymine is only going to base pair with the adenine. This means that the specificity that will be achieved. And when this specificity that will be achieved, this will greatly improve the efficiency of the DNA replication by reducing the rate of the mismatches and thus mutations. So you can simply say that is the uracil can base pair with the adenine as well as the other base pairs, it can induce mutations in the DNA. And when there are mutations in the DNA, sometimes they can be lethal. As the thymine can only base pair with the adenine, this means that it has got base specificity, it will not induce any mutation in the DNA, therefore it can actually prevent the lethal effects of the mutations. Another important thing is the cytosine deamination. Now the cytosine can deaminate to produce uracil. As you can see, this is the structure of the cytosine, this is the structure of the uracil. During the process of the deamination, this amino group, it is removed from the cytosine, and when this amino group is reduced from the cytosine, it is converted into the uracil. So during the deamination, the cytosine can be converted into the uracil. And as you can see, the only difference between the cytosine and the uracil is the presence of the oxygen at this particular position in the uracil and the presence of the amino group at this particular position in the cytosine. Now the problem is that if uracil were a component of the DNA, theoretically, if there was uracil in the was the component of the DNA instead of the thymine, the repair system would not be able to distinguish the original uracil from the uracil originated by the deamination of the cytosine. Now, if using the thymine make it way easier and more stable, as any uracil inside the DNA must come from a cytosine, so it can be replaced by a new cytosine. So this is one of the important thing, that if there is uracil in the DNA, you are 100% sure that this is the deamination from the cytosine. So the repair system is going to remove this uracil from the DNA, as this can cause mutation. So if there is thymine, this means there will be no, there can be no deamination process, because the cytosine cannot deaminate into the thymine. Now what happened is that if there is a deamination process, and that deamination process convert the cytosine into a uracil, this particular mismatch, this particular mismatch is actually recognized by the repair system. And what the repair system do is that it is going to remove this uracil. And once this uracil has been removed, you are actually having a baseless nucleotide at this particular position. Now this baseless nucleotide is removed by the repair system, leaving a small hole in the DNA backbone. And once there is a hole in the DNA backbone, this hole is filled by the DNA polymerase, and the gap is then sealed by a ligase. What this means is that the presence of the uracil again in the DNA can be responsible for mutations, because if there is uracil in the DNA, that means that will not be recognized by the DNA repair system. Another important thing is that ultraviolet lights and the UV light that can cause the thymine dimers to accumulate in the DNA. Therefore, if uracil were present in the DNA, then these uracil dimers would not be recognized by the nucleotide excision repair. The simple thing is that the thymine is actually going to make the repair system easily recognize the mutation in the DNA. And the absence of the methyl group, it actually you can say make a hindrance for the DNA repair system or the nucleotide excision repair system to identify the mutations in the DNA. So the methyl group is actually making the DNA more protective as compared to the uracil. Now, why there is uracil in the RNA? Because we want the RNA to be less stable as compared to the DNA. We want the DNA in a stable form because that is the blueprint of all of the processes that are going to take place in a particular cell. For example, if the DNA was not stable, that means that the gene would not be stable. And if the genes were not stable, that means that there are products, they're like the proteins and the RNA, that would not be, you can say, a stable products. Now, what we do is that we put a uracil in the RNA because most of the time we do not want the RNA to be in a stable form. For example, if a gene makes a messenger RNA, we want the messenger RNA to be stable for a very little time. For example, if you want the messenger RNA to make 10 copies, so we want the stability of the messenger RNA up to 10 copies. If the RNA again have got a thymine, that means that that particular messenger RNA would be stable and that is going to make excessive proteins. And if that is going to make excessive proteins, that means that the that is going to negatively affect the body and hence the cell. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends.